Hey folks, I'm Peter Brown here at E3 2018, and it's a distinct pleasure to be sitting across from Mikael Kasurinen.
Nice.
Did I do it right?
Yes, that was beautiful.
Okay, I got through the hard part. Now the fun part. You're here to represent Control. You're the director on the title. You have a lot of experience with Remedy. You guys have made a lot of wonderful games. So let's get into some gameplay really quick, because I really want to show people what this is about if they haven't seen it yet.
All right.
So if you can, give me sort of the broad pitch for what this game is first.
A broad pitch. Okay. Control is about kind of a strange world, which we call the Oldest House. And you, as Jesse Faden, come to this place as an outsider, and you find out that there's been this strange, weird force that has taken over, twisted, corrupted, and transformed the entire building and the humans into something else. And, well, you become also the director of this Federal Bureau of Control, which is a U.S. government agency that is trying to research and investigate and contain weird phenomena, strange objects. And basically, they are located in this place, in this oldest house. And the oldest house is like kind of a average, normal-looking skyscraper in Manhattan, New York. But on the inside, it's much larger than you expect from the outside. And a strange, almost like infinite world that you get to explore and also deal with, of course, the weird kind of a force that has taken over everything that you fight against. So your job now, as the director of the Bureau, you have to take control back.
And so it was explained to me that Jesse's gun is perhaps like, you know, the similar thing to King Arthur's Excalibur, right?
That's right.
Only someone can wield it, and the person worthy will then, you know, benefit and grow as a result of being able to hone that. Can you explain how that sort of empowers Jesse and how that informs the combat in the game?
Right. So the service weapon is the signature weapon for the director of the Bureau. And as said, nobody really knows how old this weapon really is, but it's been passed down from one director to another. And yes, when you pick it up, you basically, and you can survive that moment, you become the director of the Federal Bureau of Control. And in the spirit, like we have this a certain kind of aesthetic to the world, which is like the shape-shifting nature that you can see in the building itself and also in the weapon. And the weapon can shift into different type of forms. And you only see a couple of these different forms in the demo. There's more forms that we're going to introduce to the player in the final game. And some of them are really interesting, a bit more wild as well, compared to ones that you actually see in the demo. And what you can also do is you can modify and kind of upgrade these forms even further from where they are in the beginning.
Can you explain, perhaps elaborate a bit on how this fits into or was inspired by the new weird genre of literature?
Right. So I read a book, and Sam Lake as well, we read a book called Annihilation. It was like a couple of years ago. And there was also a movie that came out, I think in the spring, from Netflix with Natalie Portman. And the new weird introduces the idea that there are elements in the universe that are beyond human understanding. And that's something that immediately appealed to us. There's this kind of fundamental mystery that you can maybe get different perspectives at. You see aspects of this strange thing. But then when you kind of pay attention to the details or look at it from different angles, you see that there's contradiction and it doesn't really make sense, or does it, and so on. So it's this kind of a seducing question that it poses to you that you want to dig into and figure out. And that's the theme that we wanted to have overall for the game, that is full of mystery and strange things that you encounter, and the feeling that if you dig further, you will get it, you will understand it. Or will you?
Right.
And and we wanted to create almost this like an impenetrable mystery into this world. And we want people to come together trying to understand it, figure it out, and so on. Sure, we wanted to be a clear main plot that drives you forward. It's all about Jesse's journey, becoming the director. It's one thing to, you know, get that role, but it's another thing to actually own it and earn it.
You would know as the director of this game.
Exactly. It's a journey for me as well. And so that we want to be clear and kind of a fun and direct experience to have. But then there's this entire world around this one story that is there for you to explore and try to understand.
It's incredibly alluring, too. I think the visual design and the way that you draw the eye throughout this game is, or at least throughout the demo that I've seen so far, is certainly a strong point. What we're looking at right now, though, is also equally intriguing. A lot of the destruction, you know, the entire environment obviously can be used by Jesse to create shields or throw things at enemies. But you, I also see all these like wonderful aberrations of color and space.
Right.
How has it been sort of working in that surreal space? You know, it, obviously you're not the art director, but I'm sure you have a hand in, in giving them advice. And I just, I'd love to know more because it's alluring. That's like kind of the best way I can describe it.
So, yes, we do a lot of work when we think about the worlds we want to create and what's the aesthetic that we want to have. And one of the first things that we defined was this brutalistic architectural style that we wanted to have, which is all about a certain kind of simplicity of form and honesty of the materials. So what you see is what you get. There's like concrete, steel, glass, and wood, and so on. Things that you can understand and relate to, and they behave as you expect with the reactive environment. And so
go the opposite direction then with the rest, right?
Right. And then that acted as a basis for the environment. This is what we want to create and fit well with the world and with the telekinetic powers and so on. And then with the brutalistic architectural style comes a certain type of lighting that is strong and evocative and striking. And you can see these things kind of occurring on the screen. And then we have layered it with this interesting visual effect that our VFX team has built, which gives this kind of a fluctuating, weird, liquidy shape, which is part of our kind of a supernatural aesthetic language that we use throughout the game. And as you can see, there's this kind of a shape-shifting element happening with the gun and with the environment, and that's going on everywhere. And we wanted to create this unexpected visual experience for the player. Like, it's a totally alien sometimes when you go through it, and it kind of keeps you on your toes and so on.
Yeah, like it was explained to me that this sort of falls into the category of games where it's like, you know, item or ability gated exploration. I'm not saying the word that everyone wants me to, but you know what I'm getting at. And but I was also told that as you move about the world and if you come back, things will also be different depending on how you interact with them. So is, can you maybe explain, are these like shifts that happen permanent or how are those controlled over time?
Right. So one way how we look at the building, we almost look at it as a person or as a living being. And when you think about human body and there's this kind of thing about like chi points, for instance, all certain pressure points that have deeper meaning than, you know, other spots. And when you look at the building, we think of, about it in the same way, that there are certain spots in the building that are more, you know, let's say sensitive. and basically that's what the hiss, which is the strange force that has kind of invaded the place, has affected. And then Jesse has the ability of kind of pushing away, banishing that force and that power. And that causes the building to heal in a way or kind of revert back to what it was. So kind of peeling away that corruption that used to exist. So, and that's a huge part of the overall flow of the game. That's what you do. You're kind of taking control back as you go and do these type of things as Jesse.
Can you talk to me about the meaning of ritual in the game? Because that stuck out to me. And I had a friend once who studied the power of ritual and myth in college. And I was kind of, it sort of opened my eyes to the fact that, you know, the power of suggestion to oneself can be very powerful. I'm losing the other word I was looking for, but yeah, how do rituals really fit into this in both narrative and gameplay? Because I'm trying to understand that.
It's a part of this feeling that, you know, intent has a real consequence in the world, and we call them rituals, but really wanted to be a feeling of that there is this some conscious kind of intent that you want to have, and it can have a real effect upon, you know, the reality around you. And the Bureau itself, what we think is interesting, it has this scientific and bureaucratic attitude about these phenomena and asking these questions like, okay, there are this idea of rituals, but what does actually work and what doesn't work? And they research and try to understand it, and sometimes it's surprising results. And with the ritual overall, we follow this kind of a dream logic. So, which is a tricky word to use, but what we mean by that is that it is strange and extraordinary what you see, but there is a kind of red thread to it that it kind of makes sense. it's like the idea that the oldest house rejects things that are not part of the collective unconscious. So the idea behind that is that there are certain, a lot of items in the world that are part of the collective unconscious, things that people can understand and relate to, like a cup or, you know, or a flashlight. Like, people recognize these type of things. But if an item is, like, let's say, too new, let's say an iPhone in 2007, if you would have brought that to the oldest house, it would have rejected that, and weird things would have happened. Now, this as an idea is strange, right? It's extraordinary. But you can see the weird logic in it. You kind of get it, how it works and what it means and what kind of rules would follow. So we have the similar kind of attitude regarding the rituals. You need to do certain type of things, and things that happen kind of make sense, even though the things that, you know, do are just mysterious and weird.
This, to me, feels like a very big departure from your work on Quantum Break, which I felt was a game geared more towards mainstream audience, right?
Yes.
Can you describe to me what it feels like to work on something like this that is such a personal, it feels like a personal passion for you, the way you're talking about it, the way Sam Lake talked about it?
Yes. Yes, absolutely. Quantum Break was, as you said, more mainstream, a bit more casual experience. And we, when you look at Alan Wake, for instance, that's where, like, you know, our excitement to certain kind of things comes to fruition. And Control, to me, is, you know, a kind of a game where all of that is coming out in an exciting way. We want Control to be a more hardcore experience, of really embracing this kind of strangeness of the location and the weird things you can do, the different abilities that you have, what the enemies can do themselves, and so on. We wanted to really go all out on that and create a unique, different experience. I think something that not many other studios are doing out there.
I think that's why this game has stood out to me so much at this year's show. I'm very happy to see it, and I really want to know more. So thank you for joining us today. Thank you for talking to me about the game and sharing your thoughts. And thank you all for watching throughout E3. This is the last day of the show, but we have plenty of content to watch that I still want to watch. So like me, go to the website this week, catch up on everything you missed. Thanks for watching.